Welcome back to another episode of Gaming with Shala. Today we'll be continuing the Entropy Centre.
I'm Shala.
And I'm Pixel Cheesecake.
Today we have a slightly more awake Pixel.
Online retail is not the easiest thing to do, but... I think you put the cubes onto the squares. And you can't get the cubes past the grid, obviously.
To have a cube up here with us. I'm thinking.
Oh, I see what you're doing. That is cool. Step aside, Portal Stories, Mel. You've got a more fierce competitor. Have you ever played that in full?
No, I don't think we did. It's back when we were still figuring out sound settings.
Yep. Good one.
Thank you.
I'm picking up what you're putting down. Oh, it's trying to make you do the one thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Use one for both.
Yeah.
And then have them...
Bring it over here. And then over there. Over here. Over there. Ding. Bong. I think that's enough.
Remember the... I can't help but remember that one sketch, like... The cat that had catnip and was running around. Because its masters weren't there.
Yeah, you get back up there. I just went to the grating. Okay. Wasn't expecting that.
Gradient, I think. Like a gradient, but...
No! Why?
I think you got it this time.
Now I watch over it, make sure it doesn't do anything stupid.
What's that office number?
024D.
Ah.
You wish.
My dyslexic self thought. Cheese puffs.
English British breakfast. Some kind of tea flavored snack.
Tea chips? Oh man, those are good. Those in Canadian Smarties. They're like bigger M&Ms.
It's weird because America already has Smarties.
Canadian Smarties are better than American Smarties.
Well, which is better? Canadian Smarties or M&Ms? And also, I think the British also have the candy they call Smarties. Supposed to be like a throat thing.
Going into the controls. Oh, I see. Yeah.
Drop that one down. Tell this one to get over here. These puzzles are easy peasy.
So, entropy energy is going to be all released at the same time to solve whatever issue that they were having, I presume?
Some way to get the facility in a non-portal 2 state?
Yep.
I see you popping in.
There's a big desk over there. Is there a button behind it?
It almost sounded like there was like an alarm or something. Aha! Ah.
Oh. 3 of 76. Oh.
Works for me.
I've played enough Breath of the Wild to know what to do.
Some kind of energy thingy. Whee!
Put it by the functioning computer, maybe.
Yeah, it was only for... That was only to call the elevator.
Oh, up top, on that side, second floor.
Good spot.
Who would have removed that and put it on top over there? That's what I want to know.
It's one thing I want to see. Oh. Does Nella Lime Jerry?
If you chuckle at the word entropy, you're probably a Crash Bandicoot fan. If you're hungry for General Tso's, there is a very likely chance that you're a Sly Cooper fan. What you gotta do. Pop that on the button.
Thinking.
Then back to where you had it.
Yep. Jump.
There we go. I feel like I could carry something like that by hand.
Elements
in that office.
Tom, sorry, it's me, Tom again. Tom, the ideas guy, you know me. Has had a brainwave. What about entropy soccer? One half the team is traveling forwards in time. One half is traveling back. Ah, so cool. Now, lace all of their boots with entropy energy. Now, every time they hit the ball, its entropy time direction changes. Oh, the possibilities are endless. This is going to be huge. Saving pandas, stopping wildfires, fixing the climate crisis. Forget it. We now have entropy soccer. Ellie, hey, Tom. Thanks for messing with me. But again, prefer to my previous email, this is coming as a little unprofessional. You may want to ask your line manager if it's okay to be sending pitches directly to me, as I imagine you may want to discuss them as a group first so that they can be approved. Oh. Hi, Eric. It's Ellie from Development Planning. I'm getting so many pitches from Tom with these intense commercial pitches. I just want to say I admire his confidence, but he may need to rope it back a bit. I do want to reiterate that the human development team are looking for humanitarian-focused solutions with entropy energy. And many thanks, Ellie. Eric. Hey, Ellie. Good to hear from you now. Oh god, I'm so sorry. I had no idea Tom was sending you pictures. They definitely haven't been through me first. Tom is a bit like that. He has a lot of great ideas, bless him. Just a bit of a loose cannon. I think he's just really excited to be working here. I'll get him to come to me first with any new ideas. Many thanks, Eric. Not a single new puzzle element.
Oh, I know what you gotta do then.
Okay.
Grab that box and put it over there. Carry that one.
Mm-hmm.
Up and over to not this button, but the other button.
That's why. Made part of its history, this button?
Yep. And now drag it back down to that, so you can just back it up.
Thank you.
There you go. I think. Now the spring cube right there, and you could just back it up from all the way up there.
Can go through the door.
The jump cube, I would say. Put it in between the bar one, again, between the wall, and then over there, so you can back it up. C'est bon.
There he is. Fuck up the landing?
Don't worry, I've done that from time to time as well.
It's like I landed and then jumped.
Yeah.
Are you Pokemoning over there?
No, it's something else. I'll continue to deal with later. Somewhat solid at platforming if you need it. Oh.
Dude. No. Second more time. third more time.
Want me to try?
If I mess up this jump, you can do it.
Alright.
Not again.
And perfect.
Let me just... Aha!
Oh man, that would be brute forcing it, wouldn't it? How high can you hold one of those things up?
Not high enough. Bingo.
There you go.
Okay, idea. Death room. Just line a room with all the jump pads and drop someone in there.
From their head, from their butt, from...
In my mind, it's just death by... Or if the jump pads are only meant to do to safely repel you. A new torture idea. I had a feeling we were in space. So Earth is undergoing a bit of a fucky wucky. one, Dan.
And it's probably on the other side.
Excuse me. Open up, you dumb bitch.
Wasn't there a puzzle room back there that we could go through? Oh, nice.
Sure, you did something with that. Yeah. Are we in space right now?
I think so.
You don't seem to be dying.
If you put enough soil down, you get a plant to take root, especially if it's a native plant to that type of soil.
Fire in the unfucky-wucky way. Un-infuckening on the way. You're ready. If we could use entropy energy for space travel.
I think that's what they managed to do.
Astra is a pretty cute companion. I wonder if we'll get any humanization versions like all the fangirls did of Wheatley.
Yeah, I think the only reason that worked in terms of all that, Wheatley's BA is considered attractive to some people.
I mean, most of the people who are making human versions were basically just making a skinny white guy.
Adult Swim loved working with him, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah. That did something, I think.
I think it put the cube back in place.
Yeah.
I think there's another opening further up.
Probably. Ah, there it is. You wanna let me in?
Try further up.
Hey, where are you going?
There we go.
Where are we?
We are located in Pubble Areas 201 on level minus 4. This is the fastest route to the reactor.
Okay. There we go. Got those instant ups.
Huh. Oh, I thought you were just gonna keep bouncing on it till you could position yourself. Oh. You can rewind the stairs over there to your left. I think.
Yeah, no, it's this. Yeah. There you go. It's just a blanket. And you got weak little bunny hops. Ooh, a little energy thingy was here. Trying to hide in. With the background.
Do you think an entropy machine like that would be functional for our world?
It would be interesting. Depends on if you could, like, just point it at the ice caps and be like, reverse, reverse!
Happy jumping.
Moon crust. Concrete.
Scientists haven't necessarily nailed down what element it is, but it does not like the human skeleton.
Would you also like me to make an appointment?
springboard.
Whee!
Oh.
There's a thing I remember hearing about, and it's like the NASA scientists were like, "Ooh, yeah, moon dust, that'll be so cool." And then moon dust ended up not being anything special at all. Just basically, the only thing that made it special was that it came from the moon.
Yeah. Nicely done. There's two boxes next to the right of you.
There's a...
So, put that...
Yep.
So, I would say put the tall box over on the other one, and take the spring with you.
Yeah.
see what you have to do. There, look to your left. Up and to your left. You can get up there using that.
How far did I get pushed?
Oh, the spot it already was? I think there'd be a long jump on here.
I always expect ridiculously themed long jumps in games anymore.
Ah.
Nice!
Quick draw McGraw style.
Vegetation. A good sign. Did you know that there, that India landed a spacecraft on the moon? They're trying to find water along its south pole. Why its south pole specifically? Because the, if they can succeed doing that, they can bring up water, which
I feel that scenario is more putting down water.
You would think so, but... Oh, there's a button on this side.
Or... Huh? Ding!
Why would you remove yeet from your AI companion's vocabulary?
Because she's a spoiled sport, that's what she is.
Oh, I know what you gotta do.
Okay. Doctor,
put the box over the springboard and then place it down on the button. Then rewind it to the.
So
don't release it, but and now walk through the door, walk up the ladder, then. Halfway there. There's a stairs to your right. Look to your right.
No. Haha.
Oh, nice. You skipped two of the steps that I thought you needed to take.
What was she seeing? I'm not seeing it at all.
Oh, you know those little robots that you saw earlier?
Uh-huh.
She's seeing them. There's a long springboard and a short springboard in the next room.
Yeah.
Bring the short springboard with you on top of the long springboard. Yeah. I think.
Grab it. Oh, grab it. Get over it.
Eagle on a pogo
stick. Yep, right. Now.
I would just have more than the necessary amount of equipment if I
choose it. Work. That's that.
You got this, and
go. Nailed it. I think we'll call it soon.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
See.
Okay, nothing really going on over there.
There's stairs to the... Yeah.
To the over here?
Yep. To the over here. Ooh, computer. Might be working.
Might have a command on it. Hey, Jacob. Did you...
Astra, this whole place is destroyed. I don't think this makes much difference.
Hey, Jacob, did you see that crazy... That's a rewind event? It's crazy, right? That huge asteroid traveling such speed just went straight into Earth. I would have hated to have been down there, obviously. So happy that we managed to undo that one. It looks like Earth is already working on a plan to stop it when it approaches again in 3 months' time. Good for them. Just thought I'd check in. How are you doing, Joanna?
6 of 76 interactions discovered. Mm-hmm. Let's just say rewinding time is a $1 trillion industry. Yeah.
Something tells me I'm going to be on top of it.
So there could be thousands of... Thousands of employees. And this one employee only gets 76 emails. The efficiency of working in an office. Hilarious, ain't it?
No, it's just random amount of emails from various people. The bridges seem to be made out of unrewindium.
Oh, there's a thing right there. See if you can open that door.
Let's see. To Jamie, as a new employee, we have attached the following information regarding entropy reversal events. How entropy reversal events work and how we assist Earth. Step 1. The Entropy Centre detects potential cataclysmic event on Earth. Step 2. Cataclysmic event is analyzed for severity and likeliness. Step 3. The Entropy Centre prepares for entropy reversal event by 3A, generating enough entropy energy via energy puzzle solutions. 3B. Confirming with the board that entropy reversal event should take place. Step 4, activating entropy device and rewinding Earth a specified number of years. Step 5, information of cataclysmic event is set to the newly rewound Earth. Step 6, Earth recorrects their course on the timeline. Step 7, cataclysmic event now avoided due to recorrection. Let me in.
I see what you gotta do now.
Okay.
Put that one bridge back up and grab the... Grab that and put it on the... Put it underneath the temporary bridge where it would be by the door.
Oh. I'm thinking differently.
You're thinking smarter than I am.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe. Make the physics bug out for a second. And bingo. What's this button?
2035.
Okay. Type species extinction, natural disasters,
ecological collapse, asteroids, nuclear annihilation's hilariously low. Other is higher than by 1.3%.
AI uprising.
Are you surprised by that one?
Yeah. I don't think with our level of AI right now. Our temperature population 8.9 billion plus 600 million. I wonder what plus 600 million means. Perhaps aliens?
Or just people who are, who be just way too much.
I thought you were talking about people fucking.
Or cloning.
Yeah, 20, year 2035.
Where's the coffee maker? There's usually a coffee maker in these types of meetings that clearly could have been emailed. Oh
right
my
here.
God, there are two.
Yep.
There's one behind.
A lot of coffee cans.
Caffeination and decaffeination.
Yep. I feel like the white machine would be for decaf. Black one would be for caffeinated.
Depends on preference on company and all that nonsense. Ooh. Springboards and buttons. You'll need to put it on both buttons and the into the thing, won't you?
See any other springboards?
Nope.
No, never mind. There was stairs.
Hmm.
Over. Stop. And
hmm.
think we'll call it here.
Sounds good. Thank you for watching a wonderful episode of Gaming with Shala. He's been Shala.
He's been Pixel.
We will see all of you in whatever we decide to record next. Thank you, and have a lovely day, night, evening, Labor Day. Labor Day, or whatever holiday it is. I know yesterday was National Kitten Day, I think.
You must be kidding me.
I'm not kidding around.
Not for now.
The day before that was National Bowtie Day, so... Before I go completely off the rails, buh-bye!
Buh-buh-buh-bye now!